Hi, this is Dr. Patrick Cunningham, Associate Professor of Mechanical Engineering at Rose Holman Institute of Technology. Welcome back to the Skillful Learning Series on Metacognition. Recall that metacognition is the knowledge and regulation of our own thinking processes. In this video, Optimizing Our Thinking, we will focus on how we can make refinements during a learning experience. That is, how we can monitor and control our thinking. Metacognitive monitoring and metacognitive control are closely linked. Metacognitive monitoring is noticing how a task is going while we are working on the task. For example, we may feel stuck on a homework problem, or we may realize we have spent too much time on one exam problem. Metacognitive control is acting in response to what we find. For example, we may seek help from a friend by asking them to critique our approach to a homework problem as we explain it. Or we may move to another exam problem to ensure we have time to attempt all the problems. So monitoring our learning enables us to control and improve our learning and our performance. We can optimize our practice by engaging in cycles of monitoring and control while we study. First, we need to accurately assess our approaches to learning and the quality of our learning. Then, we need to eliminate ineffective and inefficient practices and adopt and refine proven learning strategies. To help illustrate metacognitive monitoring and control, let's consider the experiences of Joe on a recent homework assignment. Joe spent over an hour on one problem and was still unable to arrive at the correct answer. Joe thought that if he kept working harder, re-entering the calculations into his calculator, and looking over his work, he would figure out his mistake. But he didn't. Joe became frustrated and as a result lacked the motivation to attempt the other problems. For this problem, Joe had chosen to apply the principle of conservation of energy and never stopped to consider if he had correctly defined the system, if he had properly defined the inputs, or even if he had chosen the right principle. The following day, Joe asked a friend how she had solved the problem. Joe scribbled down a few notes, went back to his room, and followed the steps his friend had suggested. Joe was pleased that he was able to arrive at the correct answer. You may have similar experiences to Joe. Maybe you have become frustrated while struggling with a concept or an assignment. Maybe you have given up too soon without searching for an alternative path to a solution. Or maybe you have spent too much time being stuck on a problem. In the midst of the struggle, you may have thought, "This is taking forever!" Recognizing these circumstances is a form of metacognitive monitoring. It is putting what you are doing in the context of what you were expecting. How you respond to these cues impacts your learning and motivation, and how quickly you are able to move forward. In other words, your intentional control over your thinking matters. Joe first monitored his cognitive processes at the end of his solution by checking his answer with the posted answer. When he saw his answer didn't match, he went back through his calculations to check that he was doing the work correctly. However, Joe did not question his approach to the problem. For example, he did not check to see if he had made the right decisions for which principle to apply or what assumptions to use. Furthermore, for a significant period of time, Joe repeatedly tried the same approach without a different result. This led to a decrease in his confidence and motivation to try another problem. Because Joe did not sufficiently monitor his thinking processes while trying to solve the problem, he was not well prepared to change what he was doing. The following day, Joe did do something different by talking to a friend. He asked his friend for the steps to the solution. Using these steps, Joe was able to get the correct answer, but he missed an opportunity to gain a deeper understanding of when to apply one principle versus another. Joe could have enriched his learning if instead he asked his friend to critique his thinking while he explained his approach to the problem. How can we implement monitoring and control in our learning? We can use Kolb's experiential learning cycle as a framework to guide us. Kolb's experiential learning cycle is comprised of four stages: concrete experience, reflective observation, abstract conceptualization, and active testing. Completing one cycle leads to another cycle. You can enter the cycle at any point, and completing successive circuits of the cycle yields deep and meaningful learning. Deep learning can be characterized by the ability to apply concepts flexibly, that is, transferring and using them in new situations. Each stage is necessary. Concrete experience refers to doing something. We will call this stage "do it." Reflective observation is reviewing or going over the experience, gathering the facts. We will call this stage what? Abstract conceptualization means reasoning through your observations of the experience and making sense of them. This step can yield new interpretations and self-awareness and leads to deeper understanding. We will call this stage so what? Active testing is the process of translating your new understanding to possible actions and naturally leads to applying new or modified approaches in another concrete experience. We will call this stage now what? Monitoring is embodied in the what and so what stages, and control is realized in the now what and do it stages. We can apply this cycle to our individual study sessions and to our overall approaches to learning. To see how this cycle works, let's consider monitoring and controlling in preparations for an exam. We enter the cycle at the now what stage, making plans based on our analysis of the last exam experience and the review sheet provided by the instructor. Additionally, we have collected homework assignments and quizzes for topics on the review sheet. As promoted in the planning for our thinking module, we reserved multiple study sessions over several days in our schedule, 2 50-minute sessions each day over 5 days. This plan acknowledges trade-offs with other courses and intentionally captures time in our schedule to prepare for the exam. Our first 50-minute session starts with the do it stage. We test our understanding of the topics on the review sheet by using recall. We take about 10 minutes to write down everything that we know on each topic without looking anything up. For example, we may list theoretical concepts, equations, and possible assumptions. Then we take another 15 minutes to review our notes and textbook to check the accuracy of our recall. We begin monitoring in the what stage by noting what we got right and where we struggled in recall, paying particular attention to the gaps and errors in our lists. In the so what stage, we interpret our observations. We recognize our need to focus our limited study time on our weaknesses. This leads to control actions in the now what stage, where we make plans for our remaining exam study sessions. This evening, in each of the remaining mornings, we will do individual study sessions on each topic, beginning with our weak areas. We will start each session with a 5-minute recall and review. Then we will set up 3 problems, drawing diagrams and stating assumptions. Ask and work out what-if scenarios on 2 already solved problems. And create 1 problem, applying the concept to a system we choose. The evening study session on each of the remaining days will be a group session where we share and explain our what-if scenarios and solutions, and work each other's made-up problems. This provides opportunities for us to use and check our understanding and clear up remaining confusions. In our individual 50-minute session that evening, we start with a quick recall and review over our weakest topic. We note that we have improved but still have some gaps. Next, we move on to setting up problems. After 20 minutes, our check interval, we start a what stage and note that we are progressing slower than we expected. We have just started our 2nd problem, but our study time has been quiet and free of distractions. In so what, we attribute our slow progress to our lack of understanding. We generate several options in our now what stage. We could go over our notes again, take our questions to our TA or instructor, or explain and discuss our confusion with a friend. We decide to take 10 minutes and go over things with our friend who is nearby. We do it. And then we enter another what stage, noting that with our friend's help, we have identified the gap in our understanding, and we have a new analogy that clarifies our understanding. This leads to another so what stage, where we recognize we feel more confident and are motivated to get back to our study session plan. Now what? We return to set up 2 more problems, but cut the what ifs in favor of creating 1 problem on our own. Again, we do it. We complete the 2 setups in 5 minutes, sketch our idea for a problem, and set up its solution. With 10 minutes to go, we stop and ask another what. We note that we have made faster progress and have created a problem related to something we are interested in. So what? We realize we are getting it. We have improved our ability to use the concept. Now what? We want to make sure we capture this new understanding and decide to summarize these key insights. In our final do it for this study session, we create a graphic of our analogy, annotated in our own words. We plan to share it with the group the next evening. And so our exam preparations continue. Note that some of the learning cycles focused on the bigger picture of our process, while others focused on improving our understanding and ability to use the concepts. You should be monitoring and controlling both your process and your level of understanding as you study, too. This example is just one possible implementation of the learning cycles. Learning cycles are flexible and can incorporate a variety of learning strategies, such as those introduced in the Knowing About Thinking module. The important thing is that you complete each learning cycle, that you make future plans based on evidence from your prior experiences, and that you continue to examine how well your approaches are working. See the supplemental materials with this video for prompts to help you monitor and control your learning processes and understanding. In summary, take time as you study to monitor yourself, and follow up by taking appropriate control actions to improve your learning. The important part of control is that you come back and monitor how things are going after the change. Remember, don't give up too early, but don't struggle for too long before you adjust. Persist productively. Try something new if what you've been doing isn't working. Use the learning cycle. Do it, and then ask what, so what, and now what, to facilitate your progress. Through metacognitive monitoring and control, you capture the lessons from your learning experiences, learn more about yourself, and grow as a skillful learner. You specifically broaden your knowledge of yourself, learning tasks, and strategies. Over time, monitoring and control will become more natural, and the learning cycle will become automatic, and metacognition will be improving your understanding and your learning process. Ultimately, you are in control of your learning. So what will you do differently next time as you study to monitor and control your learning? Whatever you do, make sure you monitor both your process and your level of understanding. Respond to your monitoring and take intentional action based on what you have learned about yourself. Be strategic. Continue monitoring how your adjustments are working and make further refinements as needed. Thank you again for your attention as we have examined metacognitive monitoring and controlling. I hope you find these tools useful as you seek to optimize your learning.